Hey YouTube, we are Index Music, and welcome back today as we answer the most fundamental and crucial question of what is tonal harmony. So when you're talking about tonal harmony, you can probably use functional harmony as sort of a synonym for tonal harmony. That is to say, the chords have a purpose or function within the key that you're playing. But before we talk about that, let's just go over the three basic regions that we have in tonal harmony. So in the bottom of the map, we have our tonic region, which is basically where everything wants to return to. It's what everything is calibrated to. That's why we've kind of used this home icon down here to indicate where everything returns inevitably, ultimately, right? Up here, we have our subdominant region. These chords have some sort of elevation that then want to dip back down to the tonic region. And over here, as indicated by the mountain. And then over here, we have our dominant region, where all the dominant region chords reside, indicated by our choppy waters hieroglyph. That kind of creates, or indicates, I should say, tension that wants to go also inevitably back to the tonic region. So when you're looking at these three regions, as you can see indicated by these hieroglyphs I was just mentioning, these symbols, the house, the mountain, and the choppy waters with the boat on it, they basically all represent this basic idea that all music is tension and release. And some regions have a bit more tension than others, right? So that dominant region has a bit more than the subdominant region does, all right? And ultimately, everything is calibrated to where our one chord is. If you've ever learned or played a scale before, you probably see this. When you jump from one scale to the next, they all sound the same, but they're recalibrated to wherever your first note is. And that's basically what we're talking about when it comes to tonal harmony. So let's do something that exercises this or applies this idea. So let's plug in a chord progression in our Mapping Tonal Harmony Pro as it is now. We're just gonna go 1, 4, 5, back to 1. So C, F, G, C. We can see these chords functionally. That is to say, what purpose they serve within the key that we're playing in, or what purpose they serve within the map we're using. So we have 1, 4, 5, 1. I can see them exclusively as Roman numerals or as functions if I just click on that button right there. Now I see C, F, G, C as 1, 4, 5, 1. Let's go back to the chord names for a second. All right, let's change keys. All right, we'll go to the key of G. All right, so now it becomes G, C, D, G. You'll notice our map has not changed because in tonal harmony, that's the whole point, right? The places that we go to and from never change, just what key we're in, right? And let's look at the chords again functionally. Still, 1, 4, 5, 1. So the name of the chord is really not as important as what role or purpose it serves when you're thinking of tonal harmony. So another point worth noting is that in Mapping Tonal Harmony Pro, we're showing the major and minor keys simultaneously. So all the chords on the outsides of the circles that we have on the map represent chords you would find in the major key, and the chords on the inside are ones of the minor key. So you can merely navigate G major and G minor at the same time. If you want to write in G minor, let's write the same chord progression we have over there. Let's go G minor, C minor, D7, G minor. So there I was just using all chords on the insides of the circles, and now I have a minor 1-4-5-1 progression in the key of G minor. Or if I want to switch to C minor, there we go. So you'll notice on the map, the chords always change when I change keys. So there they are in G, there they are in E flat, there they are in F sharp or G flat. But if I want to look at the map functionally, you'll notice they don't change. And that's the whole point of tonal harmony, is that when I go from one key to the next, how I navigate one region to the next does not matter, does not change, right? When you start seeing your chords as functionally, as what role do they serve, what purpose do they serve, it makes sort of demystifying or decoding music a lot easier, a lot more accessible, all right? When you see that a lot of songs are just 1, 5, 6, 4, it sort of makes them be a bit easier to approach, all right? And there are lots of examples of a chord progression being used And starting to look at your chords functionally is the whole point of tonal harmony and what we're trying to talk about here. So once again, the map never changes with regard to how the chords function, only their names. Boom, boom, this, this, or that. So I hope that was helpful. Like we always say, keep your comments and questions coming. If you want to stay up to date on recent content that we're putting out there, like and subscribe. Keep coming back. We really appreciate it. Thanks for watching.